Although it is located at its heart, Switzerland is not part of the European Union. Instead, together with Iceland, Liechtenstein and Norway, it is part of EFTA, the European Free Trade Association. EFTA and EU countries together form the European Economic Area. Entry in the country, as well as your chances of obtaining a residence and work permit, will vary depending on whether you come from a EEA country or from a third-party country. Switzerland is one of the 26 European countries that make up the Schengen area. The Schengen area has no internal border controls and shares one common visa that allows entry to all countries in the Schengen agreement. If you are a citizen of a Schengen country, or if you hold a visa for a country within the agreement, you can travel freely to Switzerland. On the contrary, with a few exceptions, for example Australia, Canada and the US, if you are from a non-EU country, you need to apply for an entry visa at the Swiss embassy in your home country. For short stays, you can apply for a Schengen visa. If you intend to stay longer than 90 days, you need a Swiss national visa, usually, to obtain a visa. In addition to the usual identity papers, you will need to prove that you have enough means to support you for the duration of your stay, and that you have health and accident insurance coverage. Independently of where you come from, if you intend to stay longer than 90 days, you must register at the local resident registration office within 14 days of your arrival and get a residence permit. There are many different types of residence and work permit in Switzerland. Their specifics, as well as the conditions you must fulfill in order to apply, vary depending on whether you are from the EU or EFTA, or from a third-party country. The procedures for EU citizens are relatively straightforward. Depending on your situation when applying for residence, you are likely to be issued either a L or a B permit. L permits are short-term residence permits, lasting for 1 year, and usually issued to foreigners that have a short-term work contract. You might also be issued an L permit if you plan to come into the country to look for work. If you have an employment contract for more than 12 months, or you are self-employed, you will likely be issued a B residence permit. With a B permit, you are entitled to stay in the country and legally take up work for 5 years. After 5 years, you can either renew the B permit, or you might choose to apply for a settlement permit, which will enable you to take up permanent residence in Switzerland. If you are coming from a third country, it is much harder to obtain a residence and working permit. First of all, unless you are joining a family member already living in Switzerland, you will only be issued a permit if you have an employment contract before you enter the country. You will need an entry visa, which you must apply for at the Swiss embassy in your country. But prior to that, your Swiss employer has to sponsor you for a working permit. This is not an easy task. In fact, Switzerland only makes about 7,500 permits available annually to people from outside the EU. So to obtain one, your employer has to prove that you bring unique skills, and that they could not fill that position with someone coming from Switzerland or the EU. If your employer succeeds in doing this, and there are still permits available, you will be issued an L or a B permit. L permits are usually given to foreigners that have a short-term work contract, whereas if you have a permanent contract, you might be issued a B. Note that many of the most popular cantons, such as Zurich and Geneva, run out of their quotas very early in the year. In that case, you might be issued an L, even though you would normally qualify for a B permit. In both cases, the permits are valid for 1 year, but the B permit is renewable indefinitely, whereas the L permit is only renewable once. Moreover, the L permit is usually tied to a specific job, and you might not automatically get a new permit if you change jobs. In both cases, your residence permit is tied to your work, so if you find yourself unemployed, you are likely to lose your residence permit as well. It is important to realize that, at least technically, neither permit grants third country citizens the automatic right to bring family members to Switzerland. However, cantonal migration authorities commonly allow your spouse and children under 18 to join you under the family reunification program, provided that you can prove that you can support everyone financially and that you have enough living space for your family. If you plan to have your family joining you in Switzerland, you'll need to first apply for your family visa through the Swiss embassy or consulate in your home country. And once they are here, they must register in your canton of residence for a residence permit. Note that if your spouse intends on looking for work, it is important to mention this when registering, or you may be issued a permit without gainful employment, which allows to stay in Switzerland, but not to work, unless your spouse finds an employer willing to go through the sponsoring procedure. This does not apply to family of the staff that works in foreign embassies, or in intergovernmental organizations, which are issued a special type of permit called CI, and that allows them to stay and work in Switzerland as long as their spouse does. Students also have special conditions. If you plan to study in Switzerland, you will be issued a student B or L permit. To apply for one, you have to give proof that you are enrolled in a Swiss school, and that you have the financial means to support you in your studies. This permit allows you to stay, and after an initial 6-month period, you are even allowed to take up work, although for a maximum of 15 hours a week. After completing your study, you are usually given a short extension, in which you are allowed to look for a job.